Tony Brady is one of the best strength and conditioning trainers in the business. He's worked for many, many years with some of the top athletes, from Diego Corrales to Andre Ward to right now he's working with Amir Khan. We're here, the fight's here. How was training camp?
It was a good camp. He's strong, he dedicated himself, he was there for about 3 months. He's ready.
How hard does Amir Khan work every day?
He works very hard. Amir, once he gets in training camp, he dedicates himself. And it's, you know, from the moment he wakes up to the moment he goes to sleep, it's all, you know, it's all focused training.
It's a great fight, Khan Alexander. It's very close. What does Amir need to do to pull this off?
You know, Amir needs to just keep showing that he can be disciplined, you know, that he's learning, he's growing as a fighter, and he can apply that when he gets into the fights. You know, Virgil's teaching him a lot, and it just has to keep showing in the fights.
Last time I interviewed you was at the convention. Amir stopped by for 2 minutes. It was a Mayweather's fight. Now they're talking about Amir Khan Mayweather if the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight doesn't happen. What do you think about that fight?
You know, Amir wants that fight, so if they can make it happen, then I want it for him. But hey, either way, you know, there's plenty of opportunities out there for him. He just has to keep winning.
You've been around boxing how many years now?
Starting 2002.
12, 13 years. What makes Amir Khan so unique as a fighter?
He has the heart. You can just tell that he loves fighting and he's passionate about what he does.
And Tony, we have another member of the team over here.
That's Kalei.
Kalei, she does massages. Why do the athletes, let me ask you, why do the athletes need massages?
It helps keep them fresh.
To prevent injury?
Prevent injury. Helps them be able to do what they need to do.
Is that something common for athletes to get massages?
Yes.
Why?
She works with Andre Berto, Amir Khan, and she works with like a bunch of the Raiders and the Golden State Warriors. She's got a great...
You have the best job in the world.
Yeah. 49ers, I think. Yeah, everybody.
Is it...
What tiring.
Basketball players, football players, or boxers? Who are the coolest to be around?
Boxers.
Why?
They're nicer. Amir's like family. And when you get an intimate relationship with not just the boxer, trainer...
Amir is a very nice person.
Like
very down to earth.
Brother.
NBA players tend sometimes to go a little Hollywood. A football player, a lot, but... What do you wish Amir on the eve of his fight?
I wish him the best of luck. Stay healthy, everything goes well, and come out with the win.
You want to see him fight Floyd next?
I want to see it. Make it happen.
What happens in that fight?
Honestly, I don't know anything about boxing, so I couldn't tell you.
Let me get your response, Tony. Floyd Money Mayweather tonight, he did an interview with Showtime and he said, Manny, I called you out 2 years ago to take a drug test. I called you out. I offered you $40 million. You lost two fights since then, but let's put that behind us. Let's fight May 2nd.
Everyone wants that fight. So, you know, if it's meant to be, I want to see it happen too.
Everybody want to follow you? Or fighters want questions, advice? TonyBrady310 on Instagram?
Yes.
And the Twitter?
Tony_Brady. And Kalei has a Instagram also.
What's the Instagram?
Kolohe Kalei.
How do you spell that? Are you Hawaiian?
I am. KOLOHE_KALEI.
What does your name mean?
It means mischievous Kalei.
Did you know that?
I did not, but I know Kalei. Keeping the base up.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Right here with Team Conf, EsNewsReport.com. I'm Melly Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback. And just to give you guys a sense of what's going on here at the MGM, 2 seconds ago, there were like 3,000 cowboys here, but I think they all dispersed. Oh, here's one. And they're all really, really drunk. Or on the way to drink.